It's been almost 60 days since the flight operations were completely halted in India, but now they are once again likely to start from Monday, that is the 25th of May. But however, they would be a staggered flight operations would begin on Monday. There is a new normal, which is something that you're likely to witness once you come to the airport. First and foremost is this. This is the e-boarding facility which has been provided by the airports. This is to ensure two things really. First and foremost, that there is no overcrowding that takes place at the inside, at the ticketing counter. And secondly, that the passengers at themselves can, take at ease and try and identify their own seats and where do they want to sit. And essentially to ensure that there's not an overcrowding that takes place inside. Secondly, the moment you enter inside, you have these separate queues which have been created. Now, the idea behind them is to once again ensure that there is not overcrowding that takes place. Sanitizing of areas is something you'll witness constantly here. People sanitizing the entire area, the housekeeping staff of the GMR. But the moment you enter inside, there are two things that you must keep in consideration when you're trying to board a flight. First and foremost being that you would have to either showcase an Arogya Setu app on your phone, or secondly, you have to fill a self-declaration form before entering inside. The moment you stand in here, you would have to show that app to the security personnel who have been stationed here, and only after that would they be allowed. We will have to go through a thermal scanning of sorts before we go inside, sir. Agar hume check kare to please. There you can see my thermal scans have come out. It says 97.1. Sir, kya ye theek hai? Normal mein, sir. He says this is well within the reach. Now, the moment you enter inside, your baggages are something that could be a possible carrier of the virus as well. And that is something which will be sanitized here in the bag sanitizing zones. We'll take a bag right now and we'll try to, once again sanitize it. I'll ask my camera person to just pass on his bag at this particular point and we'll sanitize it for you. We'll try and show you as to what exactly will happen. The moment you put the bags inside, it will be covered by the... It will be essentially covered by the sanitizer, by the UV rays, and at the same time, this would come in from this area. Now, this has been to ensure, and first and foremost, to ensure that once that essentially does come in, you would have a sanitized bag that is completely sanitized, obviously, But at the same time, the moment you do come out, in order to further keep your hygiene in place, you have automated hand sanitizers, which have been stationed here, which have been erected here, set in place. Zigzag sort of lines have been created to further ensure that there is no overcrowding, and at the same time, social distancing is something that is maintained here. Once you do cross this, upon your number coming in, you would have these shields which have been essentially erected here as well. Now, at these shields, you would have to showcase your identification card. You have to pull down your mask as well. That's the interesting bit here. That's the only place perhaps where you have to pull down your mask for security reasons. Secondly, at the same time, you also have here a security check that will take place. Now, the security check is to ensure that there is nothing untoward that you're carrying. We'll try and get this check as well, sir. Isko please aap agar ek baar check karke dikhaye, sir. The security person from CISF checking this right now. This is something that is being done to check whether the bag has explosives or not. Sir, ye explosives ke liye check hota hai. Ye explosives ke liye check ho raha hai, sir. Is it clear, sir? This is absolutely clear and we can now take it forward. But before we enter inside, we would essentially have to showcase our identification cards once again. Now, this is the important bit here, because the security services will obviously ensure, and you can see the security service personnel obviously showing his own identification card as well and demonstrating it as to what exactly are we supposed to do. Now, we'll have our security, we'll first show our passes here, and now we'll show our identification as well. Now, after you've shown your identification, you would have to pull down your mask as well, the face cover. And once he gives that get go, only then you would be allowed to enter inside. The moment you enter inside, you have a carpet that has been laid out. The idea behind the carpet is the fact that your footwear is also sanitized. Your entire area is sanitized at this particular point, but the footwear is something that could also be a potential carrier of the virus. And that is the reason that these carpets, which have been completely dripped in sanitizers, have been installed as well. Now, coming ahead, you have thermal scanners as well, which have been put in place.
The idea behind them is for a secondary check to be done so that people and passengers who do enter inside, their thermal checks can be conducted and at the same time their temperatures can be notified as well. Sir, क्या ये regular में है? मैं अगर अपना मेरा body temperature क्या normal है?
Normal
है. मैं अंदर allowed है.
Allowed है.
मुझे I would once again have to go through the sanitizer and here it comes and only then would I be allowed to go inside. The moment you enter inside, there's fresh air being given to you and quite literally so. According to the airport airport guys, the GMR, which has essentially been covering the airport, they say that the air inside the airport is something that is being disinfected and at the same time changed every 10 minutes. The moment you enter inside, it has been put out. Now the idea behind these doors is once again to do two things: to provide you with an e-boarding card in case you've not got the same inside, and secondly to help you with the baggages as well. Now these will also provide you two types of slips. One is for the e-boarding, secondly for the baggage check-in as well. Once you do check in inside, you would have three options. Either you can write your own names with the PNR and stick it on the bags that you're carrying. Secondly, you can take out a print of the baggage slips right from here. And thirdly, you can go by the normal way as it is, that going to the counters of ticketing counters and then get the entire thing, entire slip. But you would not get a notification anywhere. You would get a notification. Unlike the rest of the times when you used to get a receipt, this is something very different. You would now get a notification of your baggages on your own mobile phones through an SMS. Sanitization is something that would become the new normal here as well. Staff members of the GMR of the airport covered in overalls and carrying out sanitization as we speak. And you can see him right here. Sanitizing the entire area, the belt as it's known, the luggage belt is being sanitized as well, and the entire area really, once the flight has moved on or for after an hour or so, the entire area would be sanitized. Secondly, there would be constant meetings of the airport staff as well as the airline, something to the tune that is happening right here, and there was a sensitization of the staff that would also take place. Once you are done with that, you would be allowed to go inside further ahead, and importantly, the frisking and patting down of the passengers is something that has been completely done away with. You would now have to empty your pockets, including everything metallic that is on you, into a tray, and you would essentially go through a body scanner. Once there's a green light, you're good to go. Otherwise, you would be patted down as well because of the security reasons. Food and beverages are something that would continue to remain open. There's been seating arrangements made likewise. At the same time, there have been two applications, mobile applications, which have been launched, and that is to further ensure that people who do want to buy purchase food and beverages can do so as well. Secondly, while you are not allowed to carry any of the food and beverages inside an aircraft, or rather you would not be served food and beverages in an aircraft, you can very well carry them from the airport to the aircraft. So that's the interesting bit here. But the new normal, as you can see, is of social distancing, constant sanitization, and the air rather being changed always, and the least, the least interaction between passengers and staff, that is going to be the new normal here at the airports. For Times Now, this is Mohit Sharma with Virajonis Gopal Dachapur.